In this video, we're going to explore how to QC a Dolby Vision master as well as a Dolby Vision IMF package using DaVinci Resolve 18. Before running a visual QC pass, validate the Dolby Vision metadata by running a Metafia validation check. Use the validate command, followed by the with lift command, to check for any positive lift values above 0.025 on letterbox content. You can validate the Dolby Vision metadata in a Dolby Vision XML file, or metadata that is interleaved in the video track file of a Dolby Vision IMF package. To do so, just point Metafia to the video track file, which is the video.mxf file, and run the validation. This Metafia report does not raise any warnings or errors. To validate a Dolby Vision sidecar XML file, just point Metafia to the file and run the validation. Once again, there are no errors or warnings shown. Now, let's have a quick look at the file metadata of the video files themselves. For this purpose, we will be using a tool called Media Info. You can check complete or supplemental IMF packages, as well as individual video or image files, by simply dragging and dropping them into the Media Info user interface. Media Info is a great tool for verifying that the color primary stored in the file metadata match the color encoding information stored in the Dolby Vision metadata. Additionally, ensure that the transfer characteristic is PQ and that all other format specifications match your delivery requirements. Now, create a new Resolve project and name it accordingly. Drop the Dolby Vision master video file, in this example, a ProRes 4x4xQ file, the complete IMF package, as well as the supplemental Dolby Vision IMF package, into the media pool. Now, you can set up the project as shown in the How to Set Up a Project for Dolby Vision tutorial video. Or simply right-click on the clip name of the Dolby Vision supplemental IMF and select Create New Timeline using Composition Playlist. Under General, select a name for the new timeline and leave Import Dolby Vision Project Settings enabled. This setting will tell Resolve to read the Dolby Vision color encoding information, the Dolby Vision version, as well as the Dolby Vision mastering display settings from the Dolby Vision metadata inside the IMF. Leave Use Project Settings enabled, and go to Format. Set the resolution and frame rate to match the imported complete Dolby Vision IMF. Go to Monitor. Set the video format to UHD. Select Use 444 SDI. Set the SDI configuration to match your setup, and set the data levels to full. The video bit depth should be set to 10 or 12 bit. Navigate to Output, and check that Use Timeline settings for output scaling is selected. Press Create to have Resolve build a new timeline, and extract and import the Dolby Vision metadata from the Dolby Vision IMF package. For this to work properly, Resolve's color science must be set to YRGB, which is the default when creating a new project. Now, move to the color page, and navigate to the Dolby Vision palette. As you can see, there's now a new tone map using dropdown available. Custom metadata allows the user to run a new Dolby Vision analysis. Embedded metadata extracts and imports the Dolby Vision metadata from the Dolby Vision IMF once again. And the original metadata option uses the metadata that was extracted and imported during the timeline creation process. Select original metadata for all shots in the timeline. Now, navigate to Timeline, Output Blanking, and click Reset, because Resolve applies the global aspect ratio to all shots in the timeline, even the shots that have a different blanking value. We recommend performing a full visual QC of the HDR, as well as the SDR Rec 709-100 nits target, using the content mapping process. To check the SDR version, switch your reference display to SDR mode, set the target display output to 100 nit BT709, enable tone mapping preview, and set your scopes to SDR. To run a visual QC on the Dolby Vision Master, go back to the media page and create a new timeline using the ProRes 4x4 HDR video file. Choose a name for the new timeline and uncheck Use Project Settings. Go to Format, and set the timeline resolution to UHD and the frame rate as per the file. Under Monitor, set the video format to UHD and enable Use 444 SDI. Set the SDI configuration according to your infrastructure. Set the data levels to full, and the video bit depth to 10 or 12 bits, if supported by your video card. leave the default output settings and press Create. Then, navigate to the color page in the Dolby Vision palette. Open the Options menu and select Import Metadata from XML. Choose the appropriate Dolby Vision XML file to import, and click Open. The tone map using drop-down menu now shows imported metadata, and we'll use this metadata for tone mapping. Reset the output blanking as before, and run a full visual QC on the HDR, as well as the tone mapped SDR version. All metadata events must synchronize properly with the video content. You can also check the mapping at a 600 nit HDR target to see how the original HDR grade would translate to a different HDR target. Set the target display output to 600 nits and set your HDR reference display as well as the scopes back to HDR. Now that you have validated the Dolby Vision metadata using Metafia, check the file metadata and performed a visual QC for both HDR and the derived SDR, your deliveries are ready to ship.